Brian Powell of I Run Far here with Courtney DeWalter after her win at the 2018 Western States 100. Congratulations, Courtney.
Thank you.
You had a ridiculously good race out
there.
I mean, yeah.
Thank you.
I was here for, you know, Ellie's run a number of years ago, which still is the course record.
Right.
But that was a
stout record.
On a perfect day weather-wise. I mean, it was super cool.
Well, she's like this, incredible. I'd love to meet her.
And this is, like, on par with that. Because it was a... Would you agree it was a hot day out there?
It was pretty hot, yeah. Yeah.
How did that feel, the heat?
Yeah, I mean, it was just a part of it. So I was actually kind of happy it was hot.
Yeah.
It's like the true Western States experience to have a hot day and everyone's suffering together. So.
And it wasn't a surprise.
It wasn't a surprise, yeah. I mean, like 2 weeks ago, the weather looked pretty sweet.
Oh, low 80s would have been.
Yeah.
I would have enjoyed that more.
That ratcheted up pretty quick.
Yeah, that escalated quickly for sure. But were you just going out of your own, like, were you holding yourself back early and other women just going out really fast? Or what was, because you went out, you know, off the front.
Yeah, I tried to put it just kind of in cruise control through those first, like, 30 miles and then see where that landed me. Like, I've never raced a lot of these women, so I don't actually know where my cruise control is in comparison to theirs. So I tried not to worry about it and to remember it's a long day. And then once I went through 30, then it was like, all right, what can we do through these canyons? Like, how are you feeling? And staying cool, and then just being as efficient as possible in those last 40 miles.
So at mile 30, you're already thinking, what can I do?
Well, I mean, yeah, you're always thinking that, right?
But you weren't like just turning the switch on and like, time to hammer.
No, for sure not. I don't even have a hammer mode, I don't think.
If you don't have a hammer mode, I don't know what. Rolling pin, you just like crush. Like, I don't. You are very consistent. Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah, it was cool. The course is awesome. The volunteers and the aid stations were like, you know, just beacons of joy.
Yeah.
So it was cool. I feel really grateful.
Did you end up, you know, sort of at that mile 30 or a little bit after, you started catching a couple women ahead of you? Did you end up spending any time with any of them, or did you just kind of
shoot on by? No. Yeah, I was kind of running solo the whole time, which I like. It has its benefits for sure. But would definitely chat with them for a little bit and, like check in with what's going on for people, you know, like what's just saying, hey,
yeah,
it's a lonely day out there otherwise.
By like Forest Hill, were you getting any reports that you kind of had, were building a little bit of a decent lead from your crew or?
It didn't feel decent. It felt like, you know, still on the brink. I think in Forest Hill, Lucy was only maybe 13 minutes back. And that's the split I had there. And then we didn't get another split until mile 95.
Yeah.
So we had no idea. And then, I mean, with the entourage of women back there, like all crushers, all super strong and
you never know.
Tons of finishers. Yeah, you never know. So I was running under the assumption that every mile I was doing, they were probably doing faster. And so
were you running scared or were you running confident knowing that there's also fast women behind you? Because I think there's a difference.
Yeah, I wasn't scared. I was just like running with the intention of if they were going to catch me, that would be what it was. But I was going to try and make them like have to work for it.
Yeah, they would have had to. Did you have any like splits? Not that you were shooting for, but did you kind of know that you were building toward like a really fast like overall time?
No, I had no idea.
Yeah?
Yeah, no, nothing.
Just in cruise mode?
Yeah, and like in the last 20, I mean, it went beyond cruise mode. It was not comfortable anymore.
No.
Yeah, I was really hurting and was trying to run everything I could run, like with the assumption that people were right around the last switchback, you know?
So you were hurting, but you were the one making yourself hurt. Nothing was going wrong.
Oh,
you were
it's
just,
all self-imposed.
But it was pain cave rather than suffering without choice.
Yeah, it's a cool place to be in that pain cave, I think.
And you enjoy that?
Oh, I love it, yeah.
Because there's some people who try to sort of run happy. And not that you are smiling and enjoying it the whole time, but there's people who kind of like to suffer.
I think it's fun to acknowledge, like, right now I'm sitting in the pain cave. So
I try to avoid the pain cave.
No, go in.
Dive right in.
Yeah,
all
dive
right.
In. Set up a lawn chair.
So what do you enjoy? What do you enjoy when they're? Because I've heard it before. Like Timothy Olsen, after he set the record. He talked about like how he loved that painting and that dark place. Yeah. What is it for you that is special?
Oh gosh, I don't know. I think it's just so cool what we're capable of. So I think that has me like continuing to dive back into the pain cave and like mentally what you can overcome and physically what you can overcome. It's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you've had a lot of great performances, but I think like the depth of competition here, like, was probably the strongest field you've raced.
For sure.
Does it feel kind of awesome to like to win in that field? Like, because it's different, like kind of soloing a great performance. And
yeah, I don't know. It's still sinking in.
Yeah.
It's so cool. I'm like, we're at Western State right now. It's awesome.
Are you? Is it kind of thing like, yeah, I'd love to come back next year.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
For sure.
And maybe have one of those 80 degree days.
I'll never count on that. Feeling the heat out here today, it's like, does this place ever cool down?
No.
I don't think so.
Maybe December.
Yeah.
What else do you have coming up?
The next one I'm going to be aiming for is in September. It's the Tahoe 200.
Okay.
Yeah. So some like shorter stuff before then. For the month of July, I'll probably be sitting by a pool, drinking.
Having some Colorado water.
But definitely going to relax until my body and my brain are ready to rock again.
So do you have a pretty consistent, like, strong lead up to this race that you kind of also makes you want to take a break? Or
Yeah. And just, like, I don't want to run myself into the ground.
Yeah.
Like, I like taking breaks throughout the year and not just one.
I mean, it's great to hear you say that because you do some really long races and other long races. Yeah. And somebody could look at you and be like, oh, she's got to race long all the time.
Yeah.
But no, you like to take a break too.
Yeah. I mean, when your body needs it, then you should absolutely take one.
In your mind too, right?
Yeah. Oh, for sure. The mental piece can be exhausted. So.
So what are you jumping on the short side before Tahoe?
Squamish 50.
Oh, nice.
Is one of the ones I'll do. Yeah. I'm excited to get up to, it's one of Gary's races, Gary
Robbins.
You're
not going to do the 50-50, are you?
No. I was like, I'll do the 50 on Saturday and then drink beers all night Saturday night. I don't want to wake up the next day.
And do it again?
Yeah.
Fair enough. You said you were suffering late in the race yesterday. Mm-hmm. Did you have any low points, you know, physically or mentally before that?
I didn't have any, like, catastrophically low points. It was all just, like, I mean, continuing to, like, trudge on and just be efficient.
Yeah.
I wouldn't even classify it. I've had a lot of low points in a lot of races, and I wouldn't classify any of the moments I had yesterday as, like, true low points.
Yeah.
It was just, like, normal suffering.
Normal
suffering. Yeah.
No.
Normal pain cave moments, but it was never, like, I can't do this. It was never, like, sitting on a rock, you know, having a moment. It was, like, just keep moving. Just keep moving. The finish line will be there.
So you actually have sit on a rock moments?
Oh, yeah. Oh, my gosh.
That happens?
Yeah. Wallowing.
Little pity party going on.
Sometimes not even on a rock. It's like straight in like a mud puddle. I'll be just like splashing just pity on myself.
What? I love it. Is there any, like, just favorite memory or moment you're going to take away from this weekend?
I was blown away by all the aid stations.
Yeah?
It felt so cool to roll into aid stations and even the small ones in the middle of nowhere. You know, those people have been, like, camping out there, I think.
Quite literally, yeah.
Yeah.
In the high country, for sure.
And everyone was so friendly and just cheering and, I mean, so encouraging, you know. And then with their sponge baths happening.
Can we get this set up out here today?
Yeah. Oh, we need it out here.
Well, Courtney, congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thanks for being out there.
Oh, thank you so much.
My parents, thank you for your coverage. They were following along all day.
Hi, Courtney's parents.
Hey, Mom and Dad.